Okay, give me another little gun review, and as most people know, I really disapprove of people sporterizing military rifles. It just seems a horrible thing to do, but there's a few around that are done. They were done quite well, and they're not such a bad sporting gun. It's like if you build a sporter out of a military gun, you're pretty much gonna know it's gonna be very, very robust. Gun to have, like it's not gonna break on you, because if you're built to go through a war, then they're built halfway sturdy. Where some of the friggin' sporting rifles you buy today, they seem kind of flimsy, and it's not that hunting deer or anything is going like going to war or anything, but it's just the extractors and stuff on some modern guns are like freaking flimsy as hell, and they don't seem very positive when they're you're loading the ammo, and if the shells aren't full-length size properly and stuff, you can break the extractors off and all kinds of crap. So I've seen guns that are worth the range, like worth thousands of dollars, and the extractors break off. And these are modern guns, worth like $4,000 or something like that. And I've got like old $100 beat-up military-style guns that been going strong for like 90 years, and nothing's broken off yet. But so anyway, we get to what this rifle is here, if you haven't really figured it out already. But it's a BSA Sporter that's built out of a US model 1917 30-06. So these started out as military rifles that were built in the States for the American Army in World War One, and then I think most of them, the ones the BSA had, they were ones that were given to the British in the Second World War for their Home Guard guys, and then after the war, they had a lot of them kicking around, so they BSA sporterized a bunch of them. And I think this is a Model D or E or something like that. I'm asking people online stuff about them, but I'm not so sure what the hell it is yet. But anyway, I think it's sort of like one of the higher grade sort of ones, because they got a nice new sporting stock on it, and they straighten the bolt, take the dog leg out of it, and then they tap it on the side for the peep sight. They took the back sight, the ears and all that stuff, they machined that away, and then they tap it on top for a scope here. They did leave the mag follower thing in, but not really a problem. They got a check ring up here. Put a sort of a 30-30 kind of back sight or adjustable sight on the back, and the front's just a normal ramp with a blade front sight. They cut the barrel about an inch off the barrel, so it's about 24 inches I think now. And they put sling studs in the stock. So, but overall it's a hell of a good looking gun. The barrel looks quite good on it. Haven't had the range yet, but have to do that pretty soon. It just still does weigh quite a bit though, because even though they cut a lot of metal off it, but the barrels are quite big on these guns, so it makes them quite accurate. So I know Dad had a P14 years ago that was sporterized similar to this, and it was the most accurate gun he ever owned. But so we'll see how this one works out, but yeah, they are one of the better, quite a good action, the P7, or the US Model 1917. A lot of people call them P17s, but I guess it's not really correct. But, they do make a fine rifle. So anyway, that's just a little overview on it, and we'll get it at the range here one of these days, and we'll see how the thing groups. So, thanks for watching.